was a rascal, huh? But you think he's perfect, and you know what? Pastor Lorella's background is no different than any one of ours. And the beauty of our Father is that he loves us no matter what. Good morning. Happy Sabbath. You know what? I want to share with you how the Holy Spirit works. I got a call earlier this week. Is it Tuesday or Wednesday? Got a call from Pastor Reyes and asked if I can have the sermon. So I said, oh, okay, do that. And the title of my sermon, if you've noticed, is what? What is the title of my sermon? Ice Cream and My Father. I really should have said Ice Cream, Tennis, and My Father. And a Temerium story ties that in, and Pastor Laurel's song ties that in. So that's how, even though that we really weren't in communication with each other, it all ties in, that the Holy Spirit just wants to strengthen us by having different ways of saying the same message of God loves us. Before we begin, let's bow our heads. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this beautiful Sabbath morning. We thank you that we can worship together with fellow members, whether they're visitors or not. We know that because we love you, we're all brothers and sisters. Please use me, use my body, use my words to share your love for each of us. Open our hearts, open our minds, open our eyes, and be able to share your perfection of us with each other. In your name we pray. Amen. I just want to brag. Yesterday, I became a father for 30 years. At 10:17 a.m., I became a father. Remember, it's about me. That my son was born, it's important too, but that, since I'm up here, I'll just say it's about me. So I became a father. Congratulated my son, and I see the Lord's leading him. There is some work that we have to do with each other, but then that's one thing about my God. He is a beautiful God. He is a loving God. He is a God with a lot of patience. And I also want to brag that tomorrow, my mother will be 80. So if you, those you know her, give her a call. She would love that. I want to thank Kim, and I want to thank Jenny for participating. As you can see, this is last minute, but I know the beauty of the Virginia Beach Church is that our members are active. The members will use their talents. We have the talents here of the Tecatha sisters, and their mother was included here too, so all the Tecatha women were involved in our service today. And to our visitors, if you hear me bragging about my church members, then you'll understand why. 1 Corinthians 10:13, both these verses are from the New International Version. No temptation has seized you except what is common to man. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can stand up underneath it. God does not promise that we will not be tempted, that we will not have trials and temptations. But he does promise that he'll be with us even though through the valley of the shadow of death. And when we have our storm, as the disciples had their storm in Galilee, Jesus was with them. You know, Jesus was not concerned. It was his Father. It was he who was created. His Father was in charge. And I firmly believe that if you can offer salvation, you're not going to be worried about any storms, whether it's physical or whether it's a storm of life. And what does he know about us? In Luke 12, 6 to 8, are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies? Well, you know, in the time of Jesus, two pennies are very, very expensive. Now you can buy a parakeet for about $19. By the time you buy your parakeet and buy all the accessories, it's going to cost you $100. But still, you know, $19 is not very much. But God is concerned. Five sparrows sold for 2 pennies, yet not one of them is forgotten by God. Indeed, the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. He takes care of the sparrows. He He knows the number of hairs in our head. Howard and Jim, he knows your hair numbers more than mine, right? And Ken, those of us with a full head of hair, I think God loves us more. Okay, I got y'all smiling. Okay. But if we were going to translate it today, the writers will not use hairs. He will use the DNA. He knows my DNA. He knows what makes me tick. In fact, he knows more about me, about you, about all of us than we do ourselves. And in spite of what he knows, God still loves us. Amen. I wish I can say that being a father all the time. Yeah. And I know, let's continue. What is this about ice cream? My father and mother are good providers. Even today in their advanced ages, mom will be 80, dad will be in his next birthday, 84, 85. They're always thinking what they can do for us children and grandchildren. In fact, when I'm visiting them, I try to visit them at least twice a week, they always have something for me. Many times nowadays, we, the children, and our children, their grandchildren, will bring food to them or take them to errands to their appointments. Those of you who know my mom and dad know that whenever you visit, there will always be offers of food. It must be that Filipino hospitality. But you want to know a secret? If you visit Vic and Atiaga, my cousins, by the way, Atiaga's sitting back there. She's our treasure. She's wearing purple. I'm her favorite cousin. Okay. But when you visit them, you know you're going to be fed. And if you don't eat, you will insult them. So it doesn't matter what you've done, what you've eaten, you have to eat. Okay. But that's my parents. One thing that have not changed throughout the many years is that mom and dad always pray to God for me and for my brothers and sisters and for their grandchildren. I'm pretty sure that my life has been in many of their prayers. They started praying for me before I was born, and they're continuing to pray. When we were young, dad was in the Navy and mom stayed home to take care of the house and us. I don't know how they did it, but my parents managed to provide for us 5 children with 1 salary. And even today, a military salary doesn't go as very far. But think about it a long, long time ago, in the 60s and the 70s. We never thought of us as being poor. We did not have the latest toys and cars and gadgets. In fact, we had 1 TV, black and white. We had 1 telephone, it was downstairs. Okay. What we did have were clean clothes and shoes. We did not have very many of each, but they were always clean, they were always fit. Okay. We did have was the love of our parents. Okay. And when you have the love of your parents, you've got everything. And what we did have was that we had the knowledge of God's love. Not only did my parents give us their love, they gave us the love that God had given them. They took seriously that we were God's gift to them, and that all God wanted to do was take care of us. We grew up knowing that Jesus died for us and gave us salvation. So in our neighborhoods, whenever we get together with friends, you know, we didn't have these latest gadgets, but we knew that we were the richest in the group because we had my parents' love for us. A childhood memory of mine is the many different flavors of ice cream. Dad would bring home after work. He was a musician, a music teacher, and he was stationed at Naval Amphibious Base, and we lived in Navy houses. On the way home, he would stop at the commissary and to see what the latest ice cream flavor is. He would stop there and we would have a lot of ice cream. He would buy a 1/2 gallon, and when that's done, he would buy another one, okay? There's a new flavor in the freezer section, it would be in the house for all of us brothers and sisters to enjoy. If it's in the commissary and it's new, it'll be in our freezer,